Good afternoon. We're collecting hats and gloves for the children of big brothers and big sisters to be handed out at their Christmas party in our cafeteria on December the 5th. There are boxes in the vestibule of the church to drop your donations in. Please remember, there will be a 9 a.m. Mass on Thanksgiving Day at St. Aloysius Church.
Good evening. Welcome to the celebration of the Feast of Christ the King at St. Robert's Parish. On this, the final Sunday of the liturgical year, let us pray that the words proclaimed at this liturgy live in our thoughts, words, and actions, so that we may become living witnesses to the truth. Our gathering hymn is, "To Jesus Christ, our Sovereign King." Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Lord, have mercy. 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 proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the ancient one and was presented before him, the one like a son of man received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of Revelation. Jesus Christ is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father. To him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. all the peoples of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is and who was, who is to come, the Almighty, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Celebration of Christmas.
Jesus reminds Pilate, "For this I was born, and for this I came into the world." As we prepare for Christmas, the birth of Jesus, the one who was born into the world to be the King of the universe, is the one who has all dominion. As we hear in the prophet Daniel, in the first reading of the Old Testament prophecy, the one who has dominion and power and authority. And then in the second reading from the book of Revelation, the last book of the Bible, we are reminded again of this King who has all dominion and power and authority, the one who was born into the world to save us and to redeem us and lead us ultimately to the Father. And so this solemnity of the feast of Christ, the King of the universe, is the one who has the power over us, you and me. The one who has the power over us to lead and guide and direct us. The one who has all power and kingship over us. The one who went to the cross and proved to the world that he was indeed the Son of God. For this he was born, and for this he came into the world to testify to the truth. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And so on this solemnity of the feast of Christ, the King of the universe, may we always continue to acknowledge and have the faith to believe in the one who has power over us in leading us to the Father. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, God from God, begotten.
We may discern the truth and apply to our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all around the world rulers may strive for justice and peace as they lead their nations with humility and benevolence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For for those who live under repressive regimes, and all who are oppressed by unjust authorities, that they may be sustained daily in hope during their time of trial. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have harmed others, may feel truly remorseful for their actions and be moved to repent for their sins and be given the chance to show their remorse. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special attention book near our cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those seeking the source of all goodness may find the face of Christ the King reflected in the witness of our faith community, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Catholic educators, that they can inspire students to remain open to God's call for their lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in Christ, for George and Irene Chapolis, for whom this Mass is being offered, for all the deceased who are listed on the envelopes here on the altar, and for others we would like to remember. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, O Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe, hear and answer these our petitions this day, and if it be your will, answer them always through Christ our Lord.
Himself may bestow on all nations
Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness, as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to you the immensity of your majesty, an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember George and Irene Chaponis. Also, our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Thank you. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Just a reminder, as you're leaving the church, the altar and rosary have their bake sale. There's delicious breads and cakes that the ladies make all for the last 2 weeks. They worked very, very hard. So you can see the ladies in the vestibule as you're leaving the church. A good opportunity for your Thanksgiving meals coming up. All those baked goods, which they really worked hard at. So I know you'll stop by on the way out. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Have a great
Thank you.